All right, you guys, day 14 is going to be terrible because it is almost, it's 11:30 at night. Today was a very hectic day. I, for the first time, well, if you saw the Snapchats from that Triple Xmas party last night. Anyway, that party was over like at 8 o'clock. What happened this morning has motivated me to change phones, and I officially did today. I did a system restore and backed up everything on my old phone, and now I have my new phone activated, which I think I do like it a lot. The camera's awesome, and the processing seems a lot faster. But anyway, yeah, I didn't do a proper, like, review, but this is the, I believe it's Motorola, and I'm watching Zoella synced up to my TV. But, Turbo 2. So, I don't know. Maybe I could talk about it more in another video. But, that's something new. I ended up going to Kirkland's. That's where I got my, like, white elephant gift. And this mirror was on sale for $29.99. I have never been to Kirkland's before. Never. I don't know why I've never been, because they have fantastic stuff for the home that's not like outrageously expensive. So I will definitely be going back. Now, this mirror I am going to attempt to hang. I don't really know how, since my step stool only gets me so high. Maybe I need to get a bigger step stool. I don't know. Maybe. Do you think it's safe? Like, leaned like this. I don't know. Nah, I think it would look better if it was, I just got done working out. If it was, hanging on the wall, right? I don't know. Yeah, it'll look better hanging. And then I finally got my entertainment center in from beyond the rack. I'm waiting on one more thing. Hoping to God that it comes in before Friday, before I go to Virginia. Oh, and then speaking of Virginia, this is a personal love life update. I know I've not been too descriptive about my ex and I and our breakup and stuff, but he lives in that area now. And God forbid if he ever sees anything, any of this. You know, I broke up with him back in April. We went 2 months of not talking, because once I'm done with a person, I am. I don't know if it's the Asian side of me, but I can quickly write you off, and you're basically dead to me. And that's basically what I did to him. And then in June, he finally called me after he had moved, apologizing, because basically I broke up with him, because he started to go through a midlife crisis and started to act like an asshole. When I was actually considering changing my life and moving with him up north. But anyway, we've been doing this weird song and dance since July. Like, he comes down, we spend time together, and it's just, he makes it so weird because it's like, I don't know if he's trying to tell me things that he thinks that I want to hear, but then again, he should know me as a person. Now, I'm not really a mushy-gushy emotional person. I'm not. But, you know, we're two single people doing what we want, but yet when he comes down, he kind of sort of wants to act like we're a couple. You know? He's supposed to be moving back. He's up there temporarily. He's going to be retiring from the military and moving back at the end of next year. So a year from now. But anyway, he was here for Veterans Day, and I basically avoided him up until the day before he left. And then he was here Thanksgiving, and I avoided him the whole time that he was here. I mean, I have plans. I mean, you're my ex-boyfriend. Do you really expect me to drop all my plans to cater to you? No. And so we've not talked since then. It's the longest we've gone since we've been talking again. But he messaged me tonight to tell me that he's going to be here in 5 days. And he's going to be here until January 2nd. I did not tell him I was going to Virginia. I'm waiting to load that in the most opportune, funniest moment, because that's where he's stationed right now. Anyway, his whole response was like, I don't care, da da da, I just want to see you so bad, blah, blah, blah. babe this, babe that, sweets, whatever. And then he begins to tell me how he's bought a house. Now, before we broke up, when things were, like, going fabulous, we were looking at houses. And so I was talking to my best friend, and she's like, it sounds like he's trying to win you back over or something. I'm like, I don't know what him telling. I mean, he's not going to be back for another year. Him telling me that he's bought a house and he's moved his best friend in that's going to help pay, I guess, half his mortgage. I mean, how is that supposed to really impress me? But anyway, that's going to be interesting. If we see each other when he's here. That was a long rant. But anyway, I'm going to spend my night putting or attempting to put this thing together and going to bed and setting two alarms because, oh yeah, what happened this morning that finally motivated me to change phones was that my alarm was set to go off at 6:20. It always is. And it didn't. And it didn't even say, like, normally when I sleep through an alarm, it goes off like 3 or 4 times before it gives up. But it shows on my notifications, missed the alarm such and such time. That didn't even show. I'm getting called from my manager basically 15 minutes after I'm supposed to be there, where she was concerned. Like, I've never overslept, ever. And I've been working at this location for over a year now. Oh, I had my interview today. I don't know, I feel like I have a lot of competition, and unfortunately me working at a less busier location kind of hinders me. My numbers are not as high as other people that could have applied. But I guess I'm going to find out tomorrow whether or not I get it. I don't know, I just don't have a good feeling. But anyway, what happened this morning is what motivated me to finally upgrade my phone, so. But I'm going to sign off. I ate a snack. Something I got from my Prime pantry order. Shin cup noodle soup. So delicious. But anyway, yeah, the camera on this thing on my new phone is awesome. Now you kind of have to set it, when you have it on widespread, it's only 16 megapixels, which is good. But when you set it to the more compact, it's 21. So I've been taking a lot of pictures with that. If you follow me on Snapchat or Instagram, you probably would see the differences. And possibly, no, I have no reason to film any clips on my cell phone. But anyway, I'm just rambling. I'm delirious. I'm tired. Got a lot going on. I'm going to really hate myself the next 3 days because I actually picked up shifts at my old job. So I'm going to work at my day job from 8 to 5, and then from 6 to 10 and 6 to 11, work at my old job. I cannot believe I'm doing this. But I'm kind of using it as an excuse to finally go Christmas shopping, because my old job is for a major department store chain. So, and then I'm also thinking about that bonus little paycheck that I'll probably get deposited Christmas Eve when I'm getting back from Virginia. And oh, my best friend Megan, who I hung out with 2 nights ago, I think, her and her husband Steven, they invited me to go to the beach the 26th and the 27th, so I'm considering doing that. To also kind of try to not be here while my ex-boyfriend's present, but just to get away, because I love the beach. But Vlogmas will be over then. I am considering something crazy for 2016 to kind of hold myself accountable so that I will post. Oh yeah, I'm in the process of editing my next day in my Europe series. This is day one in Rome, Italy. But yeah, so if I try to do daily, it's probably going to be weekly vlogging because my days are not that interesting, as you guys can probably already see. I am considering that for 2016, and I think I'm going to do it. But anyway, I'm going to sign off. I'll probably start putting this darn thing together, and then I will give up. But yeah, I will talk to you guys probably sometime tomorrow. All right, bye. Thank you.
what is going on. Oh my gosh. Did you see that? Oh my gosh.
Megapixels front camera, folks, on my phone right now. And the reason why I'm recording this is because, actually doesn't look that bad. It's because my camera battery's dead, but I wanted to not wait for it to charge to cook my dinner. I apologize for day 15. It was a 13-hour work day for me because I actually worked my current and my old job that refuses to let me go. Hopefully I'm looking at the right thing because this is a new phone. I love this phone so far. But anyway, hopefully the Snapchat shots were sufficient enough, and if they weren't, then I apologize. This actually is a... It said the selfie cam has a wide lens, and it most certainly does, because with my old phone, like, whenever I would try to do selfies, it basically always looked like this with my friend's face, you know, being cut off. But, like, me, this is pretty legit. But anyway, I'm about to switch the camera angle now, and yeah, let's cook this glazed teriyaki chicken. Now, this front-facing camera is 5 megapixels. This phone has the capability to record 4K video, so I'm really curious. I'm going to give this 4K video a try. It because the 5 megapixels is the megapixel ratio for the front-facing camera for selfies. The recording capabilities is 1080p. Now this is the 4K. I guess we will see when I upload it whether or not it's worth it. But I am going to cook the glazed teriyaki chicken with baby bok choy and coconut brown rice. I do not like coconut, but we shall see how this turns out. And then just to show you all the little facts about the recipe, you can pause, do whatever. Yeah, my ingredients, the baby bok choy, the skinless chicken breasts, I have the light coconut milk, this is the honey right there. Cashews, I am not a huge nut person, so I really don't think I'm going to use these because, I don't know, I mean, will it take away from the flavor, do you think? I don't like nuts in my food. I don't, so I'm not going to use those. I believe this must be like the soy sauce maybe, or fish oil. What is this? Soy sauce. It's adorable. Look at that. It's like a fishy, which is why I said, focus camera. Focus. Yeah, which is why I thought it was fish oil with soy sauce. The garlic, which I am, of course, going to throw in my fridge because I have minced garlic already and I'm lazy. More soy sauce. These are the sesame seeds, fresh ginger root, which I think is so cool, and then last but not least, the brown rice, so. Alright, I think in regular 1080, so you guys tell me whether or not you see a difference. Coconut milk rice is simmering, I made a huge mess, my eyes are disgusting anyway, but that gives me motivation to clean, 11 minutes left on that. I've cut up the bok choy, minced the ginger root, cut up the chicken, And what do I gotta do next? Let's see. I'll make the teriyaki sauce in a small bowl. Combine the soy sauce, ginger, garlic, 1 tablespoon of honey, and 1 tablespoon of water. Okay. This is pretty neat. Something I never noticed before because I've never used Murray's. But if you like, grown without antibiotics, if you enter this number to the website, you can actually learn the farmer that raised this. Cool. Ooh, fish products. That's right. How does that compare?
And also to my subscribers.
The meat does not look as dark.
I appreciate the message in the comments.
Oh well.